Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we will talk about getting the molar mass of different elements and compounds. Again, I am not an expert in the field of chemistry, but I will try to explain everything as simple and as easy to understand as possible based on how I understand it as a student. Molar mass is the mass of one mole of a substance. It has the unit gram per mole, which is written like this. Do not confuse this with atomic mass, since by definition, they are different, though numerically, they are equal. The important thing in getting the molar mass is being able to count how many atoms are present per element in a specific compound. Let's have these four compounds as examples. In the first example, if there is no subscript, it is automatically 1, so both carbon and oxygen has 1 atom. In the second example, it is obvious that we have 2 nitrogen and 3 oxygen from the subscripts. In the third example, we can easily say that there is only 1 calcium. Oxygen and hydrogen has 1 each, but we consider the subscript outside the parentheses. The rule is to multiply, so oxygen has 2 and hydrogen has 2 as well. In the last example, aluminum has 2, then inside the parentheses, sulfur has 1 times 3, so it is 3, and oxygen has 4 times 3, so it is 12. The next step is identifying the individual masses of all the elements present in the compound. The easiest way is by looking at the periodic table. It is usually placed below the element symbol, but the safest way to find it is to look for the numerical value with long decimal digits. In carbon, the mass is 12.011 or simply 12 grams per mole. Let's have the four examples earlier and try to find their molar masses. In the first example, there is only 1 carbon and oxygen. Carbon is 12 and oxygen is 16, so the molar mass of the whole compound is 28 grams per mole. In the next example, we can see that we have 2 nitrogen and 3 oxygen atoms. We then multiply those values to the molar masses of each element. Add the final values together to get 76 grams per mole as the molar mass of the whole compound. In the next example, we have 1 calcium, 2 oxygen and 2 hydrogen atoms. We then multiply those values to the molar masses of each element. Add the final values and we will get 74 grams per mole. In the last example, we have 2 aluminum, 3 sulfur, and 12 oxygen atoms. Like what we did earlier, we multiply those values to the molar masses of each element. We add the final values and we will get 342 grams per mole as the molar mass of the whole compound. There are some cases where we deal with hydrates. These are chemical compounds that contain water in the form of H2O molecules. Let's have sodium carbonate decahydrate as an example. With this part, we do what we did earlier. There is 1 sodium, 1 carbon, and 3 oxygen atoms. Multiplying by their molar masses, we get these values. We add them and we will get 106 gram per mole for the first part. Now for the second part, take note that water or H2O is always 18 grams per mole. Multiply that to the number before it, which in our case is 10, to get 180 grams per mole. Add the two final values and we will get 286 grams per mole as the molar mass of this whole compound. Take note that molar masses usually have long decimals and it is up to your teacher if you have to round off to a specific decimal digit. What we did earlier was to round off to the nearest whole number. Anyway, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Leave your questions or suggestions in the comment section below. Like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.